So, I'm back with another makeup look. Did I have any idea what I was doing when I sat down to film this? Absolutely not, because that would just be too prep. I mean, to be completely honest with you, I'm not really too sure what this is. It's just some kind of like smoky eye, glossy brown lip with the pop of pink in the inner corner. The lip, to be honest, was what like totally inspired this because, yeah, I think you guys wanted to know what I was wearing. It was only like one or two comments. Pretty much in this video, I just sat down, played with makeup, used a bunch of products that I've been obsessed with. And yeah, that is it. So if you wanna see how I did this situation to my face, just keep watching. Right, okay, let's make it start. To be honest, I don't really know what's going on. I don't really know what I'm doing, to be honest. But what I do know is, we're gonna use my palette. Shameless plug, but she's cute. I literally have like a million and one palettes that I could choose from, but to be honest, I wanna do something warm with my eyes, and I know that Fuego has some bomb ass warm colors. Just saying. Wow, I didn't realize how gross this is. Like, look, it's like just covered in shit. Not literally, but you know what I mean. I'm just gonna start by taking my Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer. You all know this is one of my all-time favorite concealers. I'm actually gonna use this just to prime my eyes because we need a good little blank canvas to work with. Just gonna blend her out with a flat top brush. Little tip, by the way, if you want your eyeshadow to really like pop, don't set your eyeshadow base. I'm gonna go in with the palette now. I'm actually gonna mix tan and ember together. I'm basically gonna use these as my transition. Ooh. Start to buff that into the crease, kind of above the crease. I feel like I've done this one 20 million billion times and you guys probably know what I'm talking about by now. I'm also gonna pop it on the outer corner too to kind of like tie it all together. I'm literally just gonna keep buffing, then adding a little bit more, buffing, adding a little bit more to kind of just get it to the intensity that I want it. I'm now just gonna... I was gonna take a clean brush, but it's on the floor. So this is a clean brush and I'm just gonna kind of buff out the edges because I don't want a shit ton of product on me brush. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm keeping this outer corner kind of like rounded, the eyeshadow, because I'm not gonna like clean up or create an edge or anything. Okay, now I think I'm gonna take... I think I'm gonna mix Pinot and Mocha, the two like darker matte shades, because I can't choose. And I'm just gonna pack them onto the lid and then just blend them out. Wow, honestly, I have like too many brushes in my hand right now. I'm like, hello?
Blend them into the crease.
Right, what next, what next, what next, what next? I'm gonna apply some lashes now. These are the Lily Lashes Mykonos Faux Mink Eyelashes. These are really fluffy and full and thick. With 3 C's. But no, for real, these are hella pretty. I love them. Of course, I'm gonna be using my Duo Lash Glue to stick them on with. This is the best lash glue ever to exist. I feel like I say that so many times about this lash glue, but like, it's just bomb, you know? Oh, I almost forgot, we need to do some mascara. I'm not about putting on mascara once my false lashes are on, because then I feel like I coat them in mascara and they don't look as like nice. Do you know what I mean? They just look a little bit, I like to do it before. This mascara, by the way, it's the L'Oreal Paradise Ecstatic mascara. I do really like this, but to be honest, I kind of just whack on any old mascara just because I cover up with falsies. To be honest, as long as it makes my lashes black, I don't mind. Whoa, look at those. They're actually really huge. You know when you haven't worn a style of lashes in so long and then you put them on and you're like, oh, they're bigger than I remember. We'd be looking like we got two big old tarantulas up in here. Like, I kind of feel like my inner corner needs a little something. I feel like she's looking a little bare, you know, a little naked. Let's wrap her up. I'm really feeling a pop of pink. So I'm gonna go into the Be Perfect Carnival palette. And I'm gonna take the shade called Funky, which is this amazing like neon pink. I'm really sorry that I'm going into another palette. I will have a little look online and find some like single neon eyeshadows. This is the only pink that I own that's like, hi, like look at that brush, what the frick. Oh, she is not messing around. Yes. And then just in the inner corner, I also added this little guy. This is the MAC Extra Dimension Skin Finish in the color Snow Flushed. This is a highlight and it has the most amazing reflex. It's like pink and gold and it's just stunning. Like, look at that in the pan. It is gorgeous. Like, I just want to bathe in this right now. No, but for real, I will be using that on my face later. It's so pretty. It is that time where I'm going to pop off camera, do the other eye, and then I'll be back. Ari, why are you going to do us like that, okay? Oh, I've got caught in my hair. Okay, Ari, thank you for blessing me with your vocals for the past 10 minutes while I did my makeup, but we got it back to the toots. Right, guys, we are on to skin, which is probably one of my favorite parts. So first of all, primer. I'm going to be taking my absolute fave. I just, you know that? Wow. Wow. Am I really this much of a hot mess or that's wow. Okay, this is the Benefit Professional Pore Primer. I freaking love this stuff. It just fills in my pores, preps my skin. I don't know, I feel like there's a lot of primers out there that don't really do that much to your skin, like don't really make that much difference. Whereas this one, I actually feel like it fills in my pores and kind of smooths out my skin. Hello? Now, because I want to be hella glowy, I mean, when do I not? But I am going to be using a matte foundation, so I kind of want, you know, like a bit of glowiness on the base to kind of even it out a little. These are actually by Barry M. These are their liquid chrome highlighter drops. This is in the color Liquid Fortune. These are similar to the Iconic drops. I mean, you guys know how much I love the Iconic drops. I just kind of feel like these are a little bit thicker, but they're still really nice nonetheless. And they're a good drugstore alternative. I'm legit going to look like the Tin Man. Love that for me. And I'm just gonna grab a little dry fiber brush and just start buffing her in. Bloody hell, you're gonna be able to like see me from outer space, aren't ya? Jeez Louise. I know it's looking a little crazy right now, but once we put foundation on and stuff, we'll be Gucci, it's fine. So the foundation that I'm gonna be using is this little guy here. This is by NYX, and you guys know how much I love NYX, okay? This is their newest foundation. This is their Can't Stop, Won't Stop Full Coverage Foundation. I kind of go between golden and classic tan. Just sort of depends how much fake tannage we've got going on. Yeah, I think it's a classic tan kind of day. I definitely feel like you get the best coverage out of this with the brush. It does look really, really nice with the sponge though. I've just been loving a brush recently. So I feel like with a brush, you get like the best potential out of this foundation because it keeps it like as full coverage as possible. And you guys know I'm all about that full coverage life. The finish of this foundation normally is actually like pretty matte, but obviously where I've added these drops, we're looking a little more glowy. Can we please just talk about the coverage of this though? Sis. Insecurities, life choices, mistakes, bad decisions, friggin' this pinball that just showed up out of nowhere. Literally covered, and I'm obsessed. NYX, you've smashed it. My concealer choice, I know I've used this in numerous videos, but guys, I just love it, okay? Sometimes in life, you gotta just stick to what you know. And the Too Faced Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer is just what I know and love. I'm gonna mix together golden beige and vanilla. I'm just gonna start to put that underneath my eyes and then also highlight the middle of my face as well, just to kind of like even everything out. Lighter one. Maybe a little bit more. And then she's back. She wasn't gone for too long. Beauty blender just to blend out the concealer. I'm gonna keep the majority of the product underneath my eye and then pull it back here as well, and it kind of just like pulls back the face. I want to get the majority of the coverage underneath my eye anyway, because these bags aren't playing around, you know. Okay, cool. Now it is time to set all of our hard work in place. I'm gonna go in with, should we go in with Laura Hans Where are we? The Laura Mercier loose setting powder in translucent. This is an oldie but a goodie. This is probably in everyone's makeup drawers because she's fab. I'm going to pack the powder underneath my eyes, and then I'm also going to put it down the side of my nose as well because it helps to control the oils. We're going to let her chill a little bit. Look like a freaking crackhead right now. And then I'm going to also set the rest of my face with this powder as well. To be honest, this foundation doesn't need much setting, so I'm only going to use a teeny bit. Otherwise, listen, I'm going to be over here looking drier than the freaking Sahara. I'll be looking all types of crusty, and that's not what we're going for today. I just want to make sure that I set the perimeter of my face properly, just so when I put the bronzer on, it doesn't go patchy or anything. Okay, great. Now that I'm looking pale. For my bronzer today, I'm actually going to be throwing it back a little bit. Listen, I love my Makeup Forever and my Be Bold, but I do love Hoola too. This is Hoola by Benefit. This is like the classic, the OG, probably one of the first bronzers that people owned. I mean, as you can see, mine's been used and abused. Ding, ding, ding. Let's start bronzing the cheeks. I'm also going to take this onto the forehead, a little bit on the chin, jawline, nose, my entire face. Oh, Hoola's just so good. So cute, my little heart. Definitely make sure we hit this jawline because listen, these five chins are not gonna carve out themselves. I just love food too much, okay? Just can't help it. I am going to contour just a little bit. I'm going to be using the Makeup Geek Tawny Bronzer. This is their medium skin bronzer, and I'm just going to be using this to carve out my cheekbones a little bit, and I'm also going to use it for my nose as well. Just a little bit. What the fuck? Oh! Pretty pigmented. Make some fake ones because mine are just like hidden underneath this roundness. Wow, don't you just love makeup? I can just turn myself into a whole new person. House of Catfish with Jordan. And I am gonna give myself a fake nose job because, literally because I want to be honest. I'm not insecure about my nose. I just like to add a little something something. I feel like it adds a bit of color to the middle of my face. Okay, apparently it just wanted to do me dirty like that. Fine. Feel like that. Oh. I'm joking, come back. I need you to finish my nose. When I do my nose contour though, I make sure to take it right underneath my brow so that there's not just like two straight lines on my nose. It does kind of like blend in.
I feel like my nose contour's being a little bitch today and it just looks like a poo. I look like a freaking Squidward.
Yay, time for blush. I freaking love blush. I think it's so underrated. I feel like blush should be more of a thing. Okay, now this is expensive, but honestly, it is worth every single penny because the color and the formula of this blush is literally everything. This is by Shiseido. Shiseido. Is that how you say it? This is their Inner Glow Cheek Powder Blush in the color 06 Alpenglow. And it's just this amazing, like, peachy, pinky, I can't even describe it, but it's just like the perfect color for my face. And not only is it like the perfect color, but the formula is just insane. A little dab. You can unsubscribe now. That I actually just dabbed. I actually just threw up in my mouth a little bit. This blush literally has the perfect amount of pigment. Like, I like quite a bit of blush, but it's not like crazy pigmented either, if you know what I mean. Oh, I just love it. It just looks so pretty. It also has like a slight glow to it, so it just looks really pretty on the skin. I'm literally obsessed. Ugh, I could just keep putting this on my face for the next year, so. Highlighter, you guys already know. I'm gonna go back in with the MAC Extra Dimension Skin Finish in Snow Flush. I literally could stare at this thing all day. Like, look at this packaging. Ash has my name on it as well, look. Oh. This is actually a new release from them, part of their like Christmas range. I was actually freaking lucky enough to go to Iceland with MAC to celebrate this and a bunch of other new fab products that they've launched. It was freaking insane. Like, it was one of those trips that I legit will never forget, and it will just hold like a really special place in my heart, because not only do I love MAC as a brand, I love what they're about and the products that they have and just everything. So yeah. Okay. I just went on like a whole little ramble about MAC, but I do love MAC. Anyway, this is a highlighter. Like, guys, look, one swoop. Holy shit. Oh, hair freaking low. Can you guys see that? This is literally so cool. I don't own anything in my collection like this. Like, I have a crap ton of highlighters, like, probably too many, but. And I just don't have anything like this. It's like jewel toned, like it's like pink and gold. It does have a little bit of glitter to it, by the way, just for anyone who's wondering. But it's not like a chunky glitter at all. It's like super, super fine, so you can barely see it on the skin, but I just still can't get over this. For my nose highlight, I'm actually gonna be taking the highlighter in my Fuego palette, just because I just want it to be a little bit of a plainer, simpler highlighter. I'm just gonna dust a little bit over my face as well. Why not? Okay, now to finish up underneath my eyes real quick. Going back in with Fuego, I'm just gonna go in with a mixture maybe of like the orange, maybe just like kind of all of them. And I'm just gonna smoke that out underneath the lower lash line. Do I want to do this? But I'm kind of doing it now, so it's kind of too late. I'm just adding more of a pop of pink with this Makeup Forever Artist Color Pencil in Fuchsia, etc. Now for lips, I have this little combo from NYX. We're going to start off with a lip liner. This is the NYX lip liner in brown. Just brown. Do I want brown or do I want cocoa?
Cocoa, where are you? Is that it?
Nope. Okay, well, I can't find cocoa anywhere, so it's just gonna have to be brown. The lipstick is the NYX Suede Matte Lipstick in the color Cold Brew. Yes, NYX. This colour is literally gorge, but I just want it to be maybe a teeny bit more kind of like orangey. So I'm going to go in with my palette and I'm going to take Ember. Take a little bit on a brush and just pat it on. Hopefully you can see it just adds that teeny bit more warmth. And what's really cool about doing this as well is because this is a lipstick, this helps to kind of set it and make it last even longer. And then the star of the show, this. Oh my freaking God. You guys have wanted to know what this whole glossy brown lip I've been wearing is. And the gloss part to the brown lip is this little guy here. Like, honestly, I'm obsessed. This is the NARS Full Vinyl Lip Lacquer in the color At First Sight. Mine's looking a little beat. It's basically like a clear gloss, but it has this golden reflex in it. I mean, as you can tell from my applicator, it's literally brown because I wear it with the brown lip so much. It's so freaking good. Like, look how glossy my lip is as well, like compared to the top. She looking wet. Ew. But it's not sticky, like at all. It kind of feels a little bit, no, not like an oil, because that sounds a little bit gross to have like an oily feeling on your lips. But you know what I mean? Like, it's not sticky, because I can't stand like the stickiness. I'm like, oh, let's stick all over my teeth. I feel like this is the kind of gloss that will genuinely look good on any lip color as well. So NARS, you killed it. And then the very last thing that I want to do is take some of my NYX Cake That Powder eyeliner. This is literally what I use for all of my like freckles and everything. It's honestly the best thing ever. And I'm just going to take a mixture of the black and the brown and just pop on my little like B mark thing. Last thing, a little bit of MAC Fix Plus just to finish everything off. A little bit. A lot. Mini fan. Okay, guys, I think we are done. Okay, girls and boys, what do we think of this makeup look? Low-key snaps. I'm joking. So yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed the vids. We had a fun time. If you did enjoy, don't forget before you leave to do all the like YouTubery things. Like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to see more. share with your friends. And I think that's everything from me. Yeah. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch this video. I love every single one of you so much. And I will see you all super soon with a brand new video. Mwah. Bye guys.